Hi, it's Paul Heimars from Line 6 out in sunny California at the Namm show. And we're all excited at Line 6 because we have a brand new guitar amplifier, which we're claiming, quite rightly, is the guitar amplifier reinvented. So, amplify is a bunch of different things. And the idea here is obviously right from the very onset of the design of it. The idea is that when you're in today's sort of current digital lifestyle, you don't really have that much time to practice anymore. I certainly know that I don't. And the idea is if you just want to quickly jam along with a track, you can actually get your track playing back and your guitar playing back through the same sort of sound system. So, first and foremost, amplifier is a high-performance guitar amplifier. We're doing it in 150 watts and we also do it in 75 watts. This is the 150 watt version. 150 watt version has a 12-inch custom selection in the center, and we have two dual concentric speakers either side, so it's a five-speaker system. Interestingly for me as a guitar player, the center speaker is actually runs as a dry speaker, and the two either side actually run wet, so they'll actually carry your effects, your delays and everything as well. So it's quite a nice little cool guitar feature on the box there, straight out of the box. So on the top of the amp, you'll see that we've actually got very, very, you know, like familiar controls. We've got drive, bass, middle, treble, we've got a volume control, and we've got four sounds that come straight out of the, you know, programmed in at Line 6. Okay. So you can use it for a gig, it's more than loud enough. One of the main things about this though is because Line 6 have become in the last few years so good at doing the full range flat response PA systems, they've incorporated the same signal processing the DSP into this as well. So as a Bluetooth streaming device, it sounds incredible. So you could Bluetooth your iPod to it, you could bring your Spotify account, you can watch YouTube videos through there, you could even watch movies through there, and at the price, it really does sound much, much better than anything I've heard on the market in any kind of price category as a Bluetooth streaming speaker. So let's hear some of those guitar sounds. So I've put a bunch of different sounds in here just before I came out, so let's have a listen to those. Let's go for a really kind of clean sound, so let's go for a sort of strat sound of Eric's. Let's go for something a little bit heavier. Okay. As well as that, if I want to edit those sounds, I have 100 different effects. See, we've got a really nice design here. It's 100 different effects, 70 different amplifiers, and 20 different cabinets. So let's go into the categories for the amps. We have American, we have British, we have high gain and clean. I'm feeling a bit homesick at the moment, so let's go for the British amps. Dial in Marshall Plexi sound. See, graphically, it's very, very nice and quick and easy to use. Let's go in and change the cabinet. Select a different 412. Let's go for this one. Now how about we add a little bit more delay to that? Mix up. Then may want to add some different effects in the front end there. And I've got 8 different effects that I can use at once. Let's add a bit of phase to that. Way we've actually rather than actually use pots on here, we've actually gone for a much more like sort of elegant and more user-friendly way of doing things, where I can actually just scroll along with the finger and change everything. Now at this point I can actually save that tone, I can save it to the amplifier so that I can use the amplifier later on in a band practice, and it is loud enough for a band practice, and I don't need to actually take the iPad to control it. Or I can save it, the tone actually to the iPad, so I could plug it into somebody else's amplifier and get all my tones. Or we have this publish, here, which in the publish will actually upload that sound to the Line 6 tone cloud, and from there other users from all around the world can download my sound. Now the main reason we do that is because when you launch the app, it imports your music library. So you can see my music library there, which is a smaller music library, particularly for an Namm show. I have more CDs than that, I assure you. Now if I go for, let's say, I won't play this song because it hasn't got the rights to use it, but let's say I load up this track here. What you'll see on this side of the screen is it's actually just gone online and it's looked at the tone cloud via Wi-Fi and it's downloaded four potential songs for sounds or tones for me to play along with this track. They'll download automatically for every single track in your iTunes library, and it'll just pull them using metadata. So if you put a particular guitarist's name in there, it'll pull anybody who's uploaded the tone with that guitarist's name, it'll download that and you can choose the options. You then get the option to rate that tone or actually favourite that tone so that you always have access to that tone wherever you are. Okay. See, we obviously can't use famous people's tracks, however, I do have some tracks in there from my band. So I'm going to load that tone in, it's going to search for the metadata.